Welcome to all the students. This is the second problem on Grebeck normal form that I'll be solving. Okay, now in the grammar there are these two productions which are given. S gives AA or A and A gives SS or B. So how do we start? The very first thing that we do is, that is step one, elimination of null productions. Okay. But what happens here is, are there any null productions here? There is no null production. Step 1, that is elimination of null productions is not required. Okay, not required. Why it is not required? Because in the grammar there are no null productions. Now step 2, that is elimination of unit productions. Okay, now are there any unit productions over here? Is there a single non-terminal on the right hand side? Nowhere. You have small a, you have small b, but capital A, capital B is not there. So as you can see, there are also no unit productions on the right hand side of these. So again, this elimination of unit production is not required. Okay, so step 1 and step 2 not required. Now let's proceed with step 3. Now step 3 tells you that each production, okay, in GNF, each production should be of the form P gives A, A1, A2 up to AN, or P gives single terminal, that is A. The production should be either of the first type or it should be of the second type. Okay, so now consider, okay, I will just give them numbers, you know. This is equation 1, this is not equation, this is production 1, production 2. So consider production 1. Okay, now we have already seen that if in step 3, that is at the end of step 2, if the production is of the form A gives A alpha or beta, okay, if the production is of this type, then you have a lemma that we use. And what lemma says? If the production is of the type A gives A alpha 1 or A alpha 2 up to A alpha n, okay, or say beta 1, beta 2 up to say beta n, if the production is of the of this particular type, then this can be replaced, okay, by let z be new variable, and this production can be then replaced with A gives all beta terms also, A gives beta 1 z, beta 2 z up to beta n z, fine, and then z itself can be written as combination of alpha terms, alpha 1, alpha 2 up to alpha n, and z also can be written as alpha 1 z or alpha 2 z or and so on, alpha n z. So this one production can be replaced with these four production. So this is all what we have learned. Now coming back to the problem, when you consider equation 1, okay, that is S gives AA or small a, is this equation of the type A gives A alpha or beta? There is S over here. Is S the first symbol of the term? No. So it is not of the type A gives A alpha or beta, right? Okay. Lemma not required, since 1 is not of the type A gives A alpha or beta. So now when lemma is not required, then what we do? Now you consider the equation S gives AA or A. You have to check whether the terms are already in GNF. Now this term is already in GNF, but this is not in GNF. Why this term is not in GNF? Because in GNF it should always begin with a single terminal and followed with n number of non-terminals. In GNF it should always start with a terminal and followed by n number of non-terminals. Now what is happening here is this first term, that is capital A, is creating problem. Okay, so what we do, substituting. Okay, before that, so this one implies this is not in GNF. Okay, so what we do, we substitute A production in equation 1. What is A production? A production, wherever A is there, will be substituted with SS or B. Okay, so when we do that, what we get? S gives, so A will be first replaced with SS followed with A. Okay, so this because A gives SS or B, so again wherever A occurs, it should be also, the second option is, it should be also replaced with B. So then it will be BA. So this and this is basically the substitutions which we have made for A, and the remaining A you should write here. If you now consider this, I will just call this as equation 3. Okay, this is in GNF, this is in GNF, but this is not in GNF. But before that, you should now see the equation that we have seen right now, the equation that we have got after substitution. Okay, again you don't forget to check whether it is of the type A gives A alpha or beta. Now just see, this is A and this is A. Okay, so 3 is of the type A gives A alpha or beta. So this is a special case. Please note, earlier when S gives A or A was considered, it was not in GNF, but also this production was not of the type A gives A alpha or beta. But just to make this term into GNF, this term was already in GNF, but this was not. So to convert this into GNF, what we did, we tried to replace the first non-terminal with the we tried to replace capital A with A production. When we did it, the production 1 got changed to production 3. When we saw this production 3, we immediately came to know that yes, now it is of the type A gives A alpha or beta. Therefore, we replace 3 with following productions. Now, which are the following productions that we need to replace? So, if the term is of type A gives A alpha or beta, A gives A, so remaining entire term will be alpha 1, and this will be beta 1, this will be beta 2. Okay? So, first, S gives, I am just using these formulas that we have seen. I will first club all the beta terms together. So S gives beta 1, that is BA. Okay. Even before that, I forgot to do, we have to also say that let Z1 be a new variable, then you write this part you write later. Okay, let Z1 be a new variable, then we can replace 3 with following productions. Okay, as I had already written, first production will be S gives, first club all the beta terms, that is BA or A, and then, and second production is all the beta terms with this newly created variable Z1. Okay, so So then this, the further part will be BAZ1 and AZ1. So I will just call this as 4. And then Z1 itself can be written with all the alpha terms, and we have only one alpha term, that is SA, or SA Z1. So this is equation 4 and 5. Okay, so we started with the production one. It was not in GNF. Okay, just to convert this to GNF, we did the substitution of A production. Then we realized that it is now of the type A gives A alpha or beta, and then we use the lemma, and this production 3 will be now replaced with these two productions. Okay, so I will just put them in box so that we know that these are the final productions to be used and not any other. Okay, so these two productions. Now we have just considered one, no? Now let's see two. So consider A gives SS or B. Okay, so further we say consider 2, that is A gives SS or B. Again, when you have this particular production A gives SS or B, this is also not in GNF. Okay, this is also not in GNF. Correct? So since this is not in GNF, okay. Before that, is this production 2 is of the type A gives A alpha or beta? Okay, is not of the type A gives A alpha or beta. Therefore, lemma not to be used. Okay, then what you do is, then you, when you consider this 2, we observe that A gives SS, okay, is not in GNF. Although A gives small b is in GNF, A gives SS is not in GNF. Therefore, okay, we substitute S production in equation 2. We get, so now which term is creating a problem? See, in GNF, as we know, the first term should be either a single terminal or followed with n number of non-terminals, or only one terminal should be there. Now here, what is creating problem is the first S. So we substitute S production here. Now what is S production? If you now consider S production, it is no longer the older one. S production is the production which is there in the box now. That will be the new S production. So what will happen is, I will substitute each term of S production. So first term is BA. S or, okay, so then S can be also replaced with A. So then I write AS or, S can be replaced with BAZ1 followed with S, and it can be finally also replaced with AZ1, AZ1 followed with S, okay, and B, which is at the end. So this B I am writing as it is. And now if you consider each of this term, first, second, third, fourth and fifth are in GNF. Okay, all these terms are in GNF of A production. Correct? So this A production that we have, all terms are in GNF. Okay, so initially this part S, because of this single S, the term was not in GNA. So what we did, we replaced S with the S production values and we get this. So this is already in GNA. So I will just call this as, since it is final equation, I will call it as F1. Now you consider the already converted one. S gives BA, A, BA, Z1 and AZ1. This is in GNA. This and this all are in GNA. Okay, so I can say that this is in GNA. But when you consider Z1 is still not in GNA. So further I am going to say, consider Z1 giving SA and SAZ1. SA or SAZ1, which is not in GNA. GNF, I'm sorry. Therefore, substituting, what is creating problem? The first term here. Therefore, substituting S production, or I will just say 4 in it, we get. So wherever S occurs, no, you will have to replace S with the right hand side of S. So we get Z1 gives. So what is the first term of S? BA. So BA, A. So this is the first term. Then A, this is S. Then third term is BAZ1 followed with A. So here BAZ1 followed with A. And last term is AZ1 followed with A. Last term is AZ1 followed with A. So this S was replaced with all the four terms from S production. Now if you see here, all these terms are now in GNA. But we have to still do the replacement for the second part, that is this part. Okay. On the similar lines, the same values of S we have to substitute in this S also. So when you do that, what you get is BA, so this is the first value of S, BA, AZ1, then A, okay, because the next value of S is A, followed with AZ1, then third value is BAZ1, third value is BAZ1, followed with AZ1, BAZ1, followed with AZ1, or I don't have place, so I will write it here, next, here, so BAZ1, next is AZ1, next is AZ1, so AZ1, followed with AZ1, and finally, BAZ1 and AZ1. All these four values have been substituted in place of S, followed with AZ1. So you get till this point, substitution was made, and this from here the substitution for SAZ1 starts. So you have BAZ1, AAZ1, BAZ1, AZ1, AZ1, AZ1. Okay, so that is it. So this is the final Z production. So I will also put this in a box. Okay, I will just call this as final 2. So this is final 1, this is final 2, and this is already final 3. Okay, so I will rewrite it. S gives, what is that? S gives, I am just copying it. this equation V capital A small a B A Z1 A Z1 B capital A B A B capital A then A B A Z1 and A Z1. So this is the S production that we had considered first. So I will just call this as F3. So now you can easily see that A production is already in GNF, Z1 production is also in GNF each term, and S production is also in GNF. Therefore, final productions. Okay, in GNF are as gives BA or A or BAZ1 or AZ1. Okay, this is one. Second production is this full thing. Okay. A gives BAS or AS or BAZ1S or BAZ1S or AZ1S or B. AZ1S or B. And third, Z1 itself can be written or AZ1 AZ1. So these are the final set of productions. In this problem, we are again required to convert the given CFG into GNF. Okay, one thing you all note that in previous two problems, lemma came into the picture because we, after step number two, we had got productions of the type A gives A alpha or beta. But every time you may not encounter productions having lemma. Okay, so this will be reflected in this problem. So how do you actually solve this, right? The very first step that you do is elimination of null production. Null production okay. I will quickly write this because now people are well versed in writing the solutions, so I will, without wasting time, I will directly write the answer. So as you can see here, A gives null and B gives null, so I can say that A and B are nullable, right? And S gives A B A, that's why since S gives A B A and A and B are nullable, therefore S is also nullable. Okay, so that means A, B and S all are nullable. We get, what do we get? Now since S gives, first production S gives A, B, A, so all of them are nullable. So you can have A, B and A, right? Now what are the different possibilities? First, let us assume that A, B and C, or A, B and A all are there. Then let us assume that A is not there. This B is there, this A is there. Then we assume that A is there, B is there, this A is not there. Okay, and then we'll assume that this A is there, this A is there, and this B is not there. Right? Third, we'll assume that only this A is there, B and C is not there. Then we'll assume that only B is there, both the A's are not there, and finally we'll assume that this A is there, this and this is not. This can be written as S gives. So according to the first one, let's assume that all are there. So A, B, A, then let's assume that A is not there, but B and A is there, so it will be just BA. Then we'll assume that A and B is there, last A is not there. Okay. Then we'll assume that A and A is there, B is not there. Then we'll assume that only A is there, B and C, B and last A is not there. Then we'll assume that only B is there. Now, when you consider this last one, I feel this is duplication because here we assume that only A is there. So when only A is there, you probably are going to write A. Now there is already one A here, so why are you repeating it? You don't have to repeat it. Okay, terms don't have to be repeated. So these are all the terms that we get after elimination of null production. Similarly, A production can be further written as AA, assuming that capital A is there, and then just A, assuming that capital A is not there. Whereas A gives null is eliminated. Similarly, B gives B, B or B. So this is the end of step number 1. Now in step 2, we are going to have elimination of unit production. So now, are there is there any unit production? You can see here S gives A is a unit production. So I will just number this. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3. Consider 1, S gives A is a unit production. So after elimination, the productions are first, the first terms will remain same, A, B, A or B, A or A, A. Now S gives A is a unit production and S gives capital B is also a unit production. So S gives A and S gives B are unit productions. Okay, so how to eliminate a unit production? So A will be then replaced with the right hand side of A production. A will be then replaced with the right hand side of A production. What is the right hand side of A production? It is AA or A. So in place of A, I am going to write AA or A. Similarly, B, unit production here with B, how we can eliminate it? B can be replaced with the right hand side of B production, that is BB or B. So I will write here BB or B. So this is the production that we get after elimination of unit production. Similarly, A production can be then written as AA, nothing changes, it will be same, and B production can be written as BB or B. I will just call this as equation 4, equation 5, not equation, production 5, production 6. Okay. Now, next, at the end of step number 2, you need to see whether any of these productions are in GNA. Okay, whether any terms are not in GNA. Before that, you have to also see whether lemma is applicable. Now, when we consider the production 4, okay, that is this production, S gives ABA or BA or AA or AA, nowhere, okay, the production 4 appears to be of the type A gives A alpha or beta. Okay, no term is of the type A gives A alpha or beta. So the lemma is not applicable for this. If you see the second production, that is fifth production here, A gives AA or A. Here also, it is not of the type A gives A alpha or beta. And further, okay, you can see that this is already in GNF, this is already in GNF. Similarly, the next sixth production, these two are already in GNF. The problem occurs where? The problem occurs only here, here, and here. These three terms. Okay. So this kind of problems, in the previous two problems, we have seen that lemma somehow was applicable. Okay. But in this problem here, I think lemma is not required because none of the production is of the type A gives A alpha or beta. Okay. So now we can skip lemma and we can go in the further step. In the further step, what we do, since these three terms are not in GNF, we will try to replace these terms and get back to GNF. The problem over here is the first term here, the first term here, and the first term here, okay, should have been a small alphabet, okay, or a terminal, okay. So since, I will just continue, since S gives ABA is not in GNF, replacing now what is creating problem, this is okay, replacing a production it becomes, okay, wherever this A is there, you will be replacing it with the right hand side elements of A production. So this will be S gives, A will be replaced with AA, this term AA, A will be replaced first with AA, and then A will be replaced with small a. AA, BA will be the first term, and then this A will be then replaced with small a, BA. So this and this is the replacement. Okay. Similarly, S gives, so I will just call this as, you know, A. S gives BA is not in GNF. Why? Because of this B. Therefore, okay, replacing B production, okay, it becomes S gives. Now B can be either small b, B or B. So S gives, so wherever B is there, I'll be replacing it with BB followed by A, or B followed by A. So this is that capital B that is now being replaced. So this is my B. Okay. Similarly, S gives A is also not in GNF. S gives AA is not in GNF. What creates problem? This A. Therefore, replacing A production, it becomes, okay, when replacing it with A production, it becomes S gives. So A production has AA as the first term followed with A, or small a as the first term followed with A. Okay, and see. Okay. Therefore, the final set of productions in GNF are, first we'll write S production, the final S production. So this term ABA, okay, can be now replaced with A ABA or ABA. ए ए बी ए और ए बी ए एंड एज यू कैन सी बोथ आर इन चेन. ओके देन द सेकेंड टर्म हियर बी ए विच वॉज नॉट इन जी एन एफ दिस बी ए कैन बी नाउ रिप्लेस विद बी बी ए और बी ए बी बी ए और बी ए एंड एज यू कैन सी सॉरी ए कैपिटल हियर एंड एज यू कैन सी नाउ बोथ दिस टर्म्स आर ऑल्सो इन जी एन एफ देन सो टू टर्म्स आर रिजॉल्व थर्ड एस गिव्स ए वॉज नॉट इज नॉट इन जी एन एफ सो दिस इज नाउ रिप्लेस विथ ए ए ए और ए ए सो ए ए ए और ए ए एज अ रिजल्ट नाउ दे आर इन जी एन एफ बोथ आर इन जी एन एफ ओके एंड वंस दीज थ्री टर्म्स आर ऑलरेडी इन जी एन एफ then what you can do is the remaining terms you can just append as it is. Okay, what are the remaining terms? These are all the remaining terms. You can simply append them here. Okay, these are all the remaining terms. Also notice that term AA now as you are going to replace, you are already going to have AA here. So you don't have to duplicate AA. So this AA you need not write. Okay, similarly small a. Okay, similarly BB. And B. Okay. So these are, this is the final S production. And remaining A and B productions will be as it is. You can just copy the same thing. So remaining A and B productions are this. So each production is already in GNF. So this is one problem, GNF problem, which I thought it would be better to solve, which shows you that there was no, absolutely no involvement of lemma in this entire problem, and you could directly convert it to GNF. Okay. Thank you.